We would have two or three deaths every year in Queensland alone, just from skin cancers in our transplant patients.
The anti-rejection drugs that the patients take, they prevent the immune system, specifically T cells, from switching on and destroying the transplanted organs. Unfortunately, this immune mechanism is the same mechanism that the body would use to fight cancer.
The idea of this is to be in a cream so as it can be applied topically to the skin in the hope that it might neutralize the effects of this immunosuppressive medication only in the skin where it causes the risk of skin cancer.
I don't know what a normal life was. My life was always around being into hospital and treatments and stuff. So for me, transplant life is normal life. I've had two transplants, 24 years in total. Well, the cream would be easy to apply. I know it's not going to affect my transplant. And from a peace of mind point of view, I can probably not worry too much that my potential pathway is potentially dying from skin cancer. Coming into hospital and having to get things cut out, and especially in the face. This year I've got two and currently waiting to get one cut off my top of my lip.
We did a study on a sample of 100 of these patients followed over 3 months, and we identified that they needed to have over 400 lesions cut in that period. Surgery takes care of the cancer that you're treating, but it doesn't prevent the next one from happening. And that's where really we don't have many tools or many medications to actually stop those new cancers from happening.
We have a lot of very compelling data to show that we can switch on the immune system and we can induce tumours to regress. And also there's a real clinical need.
I mean, I've been around 26 years and unfortunately I've lost some good friends who have ended up passing away through cancer, and it started with skin cancer. And knowing the fact that we're at high risk mentally, it can impact patients, transplant recipients. So not only is it going to change people's recipients' lives, potentially, it's going to save as well.